And so I was making all of this money, but I remember asking myself, what's the point of having a lot of money if you're losing the most valuable asset, and that's your time? I was losing time with my family, I was losing time with my friends, and I felt like I wasn't able to reap the benefits of all of the hard work. And I remember it really hit me one night, and I want to say this was right at the beginning of football season, and I've been working hard all week. I was always doing 3 to 5 coffee and lunches every single week with insurance agents or lenders, anybody who was influential in the real estate community or just the community in general, because I knew I needed to get my name out there. And so I remember this was a Saturday and woke up and CJ's super excited. He comes downstairs, he's ready to play, and I think he wanted to go outside and throw the football. And I remember I just wasn't engaged with it, right? I'm like, yeah, in a second. And I had my phone in my hand and I'm negotiating a deal. The funny thing is, I've negotiated so many deals that goes to the point of it doesn't even matter what the deal was. Like, I think it was a pretty big deal, probably somewhere between like 800,000 to 1 million, because I just remember that I was locked in on it. But at the end of the day, I also remember when I told him, hey, just a minute, and him just kind of walking away. And I felt it, you know how you could feel that in your soul? Like, I felt like, Then I remember I got a glare, like right at my face. I look over and my wife, she's just kind of looking like, so that's what we're doing now? And I was like, huh. And it was at that very moment that I knew that, like, I was losing it, right? I was losing my family trying to chase this money, trying to chase this career. And more importantly, I was losing the bond and the relationship that I was building with my son. And especially for somebody who grows up without a dad, that everything you want is to be able to show your seeds that, hey, I can be present and you have support, you have me here. All those things were very important to me, but I was losing that because why? I was chasing the money. And that was a moment where it was just like, okay, I gotta do something different. And another time I remember shortly after this, CJ had asked me about playing the video games together. And I think it was another time where I was like, you know what, hold on, buddy, I gotta do this contract or I gotta take this phone call. And him saying, you know, why are you always on your phone? Why can't you never hang out with me? Why can't you never play with me? And in those moments, you really have to ask yourself, yes, there comes a time that I gotta work, but at the same time, am I allowing myself to use work as an excuse to not be present? Was I not there, right? Even though I was there physically, was I there mentally? Was I there spiritually? And all those things just kept taking a toll on me, kept taking a toll on me. And so it was in that very moment that I had to ask myself again, what was the most important thing? Why was I grinding? And that was where I really had to make a decision. And so I would ask you, ask yourself, even in the midst of all of the grinding that you're trying to do, trust me, I know, I love to grind. I always said that you can't complain about too much food on your plate when your goal was to eat in the first place. But at the same time, you have all of this food on your plate and you're sitting at an empty dinner table, that's no fun either, right? So ask yourself, in the midst of trying to grind, am I losing the thing that matters the most to me? And if so, you have to really do a conscious check on that to say, listen, I might have to let something go so I can gain something else. And most of the time, that gain something else is what you truly want in life. And that's family, that's community, that's memories. Because we all know you can always make more money, you can always find another deal, you can always find another opportunity, but you can't get more time. The second lesson that I learned was that you have to stay true to yourself. I remember when I first started out, I wanted to find a way to be the lord of my land. That was why I got into real estate. I knew that at the end of the day, I wanted to be able to have something to pass down to my family. Remember, I saw a video from YouTube where a guy said he or she who owns the land makes the rules, and he or she who owns the most land wins. Now, I don't know about you, but when I was growing up, my favorite game was always Monopoly, right? You land on my property, you gotta pay me, right? In Monopoly, if you think about it, you take one property, two property, three properties, then you cash them all in and you get a commercial property, which is what I've been able to do in my own life. But when I first got started, that was my goal. Is that I wanted to have investment properties. I wanted to have something I could pass down. I wanted to be able to create mailbox money. But what I found was through me serving other people, which is where my journey started off at, and I loved it, being able to help other people find their American dream, whether it was through an investment property or through their own personal home. I absolutely loved that. But what I found was that I lost sight of who I was and what I was doing it for. And I'm not talking about just the time. I found myself doing more retail and transactional work. I forgot that I was doing this to be able to build generational wealth and have my own income producing properties so I could control my own time. And so I say that to you because wherever you are, whatever job that you have, understand what you're working towards right now and ask yourself, when you first got into this industry, this career, whatever you're doing, was that what you set out to do? Because the goals can change. And remember, you just have to stay married to the destination because the journey is gonna have peaks and valleys. There's going to be roadblocks, there's going to be detours. But for me, when I looked at this and I was 3 years into selling real estate, I was like, okay, am I staying true to what I wanted in the beginning? And it wasn't. I forgot about what was my goals. And again, I allowed it to become a distraction. And from there, it caused even more frustration. And I didn't know why. I just knew that this wasn't what I wanted. But when I went back and I looked at my goals for why I even got into real estate in the beginning, I wanted to use it as a stepping stone. I wanted to serve other people, help them buy, sell, and invest. And in return, I would take my sales commissions and I would buy my own rental properties, commercial properties, whatever it was. Ask yourself, if you're 2 years in, 3 years in, 5 years in, do an audit and ask, am I still committed to the same destination as when I started? Because a lot of the times, if you are frustrated, that's probably the reason why, is because you're no longer on the path to where you're wanting to go. You're over here and it's a distraction, but you haven't done the audit to be able to figure out, okay, this is where I fell in the hole. But if you do that, it can then help you to pull back and you can then go center gravity right to your North Star. And the last thing that I learned was the power of saying no. Now I'll tell you, this was never easy for me, especially growing up as a child. I would say that I always had a little bit of FOMO. I didn't have brothers and sisters. So for me, whenever I got invited to something or whenever I had my mind that something could be cool, I always wanted to be a part of it. And I remember when I first got into real estate, it was the exact same way. I never wanted to say no to anything. I was at every networking event that I could. It didn't matter if it was a Saturday, it didn't matter if it was a Sunday. I was always trying to say yes. Why? Is because I was chasing the deal and ultimately I was chasing the money. And so I learned towards the end of me selling real estate, the power of saying no. And a big thing that I had to really come to grasp with is when I was saying yes to a client, to a networking event, I was ultimately saying no to something else. And a lot of the times, again, that was my family, that was my friends, that was the things that really mattered to me the most. And so I had to ask myself, what am I willing to give up to be able to make sure that I can go up? And going up for me meant like living life in my purpose, living life by my design. That's the whole reason why I'm so passionate about Dream Nation, is because I believe that everything starts with a dream. And at the end of the day, that dream should allow us to be able to live life by our design. And so for you, if you're someone who you're constantly trying to figure out how to live life by your design, it's going to come down to first understanding who you are, what you stand for, but more importantly, what you want out of life. Write them down. Write down 5 things that are non-negotiable. If it's time with family, if it's being present with your kids, if it's taking a trip every quarter with your spouse, it doesn't matter what it is. You have to make sure that those are your non-negotiables and you stick to them. Because if you allow everyone else to ask you for something and you're continuously showing up for them, that means that you're not able to show up for something else. And if that is one of your non-negotiables, you're going to live life in frustration. And that's my goal for you, is to be able to identify it so you don't have to. So I wanted to share that with you because those are the things that I would tell you. The reason why I left real estate and selling real estate was because I knew that I needed to get back my time. I needed to get back my energy and I needed to make sure that I was present for my kids, for my wife, for my family. And so for you right now, if you're in a season where you don't have that and you can go 100 miles an hour, I encourage you to do just that. Selling real estate will always be a rewarding journey. You get to help so many friends, families, strangers be able to buy a piece of their American dream. You get to help them build something that hopefully you'll get to build for yourself as well, and that's generational wealth. But what my challenge to you is don't lose sight of who you are and what you stand for along this journey. So that's all for this one. I appreciate you watching. Remember, in the dream we trust, I chose to take action on finding my purpose in life. I chose to take action on finding something that was going to allow me to have scalability and not control my time. And I'm living just that. I hope that you'll stay with me on this journey, and I want to continue to share tips like this. Remember, it's not all about the money, but it is about the impact. What type of legacy can you leave at the end of the day? And so I always say, in the dream we trust, but you gotta take action on something. Otherwise, that dream that you have, and we all have a dream, without any action, it'll only merely be a fantasy. That's all for this one. I'll catch you on the next one, Dream Builder.